Hi everyone, welcome back to Pretty Pastel Pastries. If you're new here, hi, my name is Giselle. Today I have for you guys these super trendy Lucky Charms hot cocoa bombs just in time for the holiday season. If you guys want to learn my techniques on how I do them, please stay tuned. Let's hop right into the video. So let's first start off with my favorite chocolate of all time. If you guys have been here long enough, you guys know it's Ghirardelli White Chocolate Melting Wafers. Next up, we're gonna need a silicone cup. This one is from the brand OXO. Some wax paper, some mini marshmallows. Now this Swiss Miss box right here is from Walmart. Now the amazing thing about this box is that it comes separately with the marshmallows and the hot cocoa mix, so we can actually create some awesome designs with our marshmallows on the side. Next up, we're gonna need any kind of piping bags. You can even use Ziploc. Right here we have some cupcake liners. Next up we have our diamond dust. So right here I have them in orange, blue, violet. And of course we have our candy color specifically for chocolate guys from the brand Chef Master. We're gonna need some silicone molds. I have two of them here. And lastly, we have our decoration, which we're gonna show you guys at the end of the video. If you guys wanna learn how to make these hot cocoa bombs with me, let's hop right into the video. So let's first start off with our chocolate. We're gonna melt this chocolate at 30 second intervals and we'll be right back. So this is after the first 30 seconds, and as you guys can see, it has melted just a little bit here at the bottom, but you always want to ensure, you know, you go ahead and mix this throughout the cup so that the heat distributes. Okay, once we have that all nice and mixed, I'm gonna place it in there for 30 seconds more until it's completely melted, and we'll be right back. So I am all done melting all of my chocolate, and you guys, look, like, this consistency is amazing. You don't have to add like any oils or anything like that to this Ghirardelli chocolate, so I highly recommend. Now next up, I'm gonna grab my small little bowls and I'm going to add colors into each one of them. And now to each one of them, I'm just gonna go ahead and add in a little bit of my Chef Master candy coloring. But always make sure you shake it up. Now from here, we're gonna go ahead and bring over our molds. And to this one, I'm actually gonna go ahead and cut them along these lines right here. Just be really careful, you know, not to cut like the spear or anything. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. And the reason for that is just because I want to individually move one by one, just like we would do to like a regular like breakable heart. I wanna do the same concept with these spheres. So we're just gonna go ahead and cut them. Okay, now that we have them all nice and cut, now we're gonna start with adding in all of our colors. So just really slowly start pouring in your chocolate. And it's okay, you can add a little bit more, we can always take it out. You can add about that much. Now from here, we're gonna go just like, just follow the sphere. And just make sure to cover every little corner. And that's why it is also really important to have your chocolate at the correct consistency, because if it's too chunky, you know, too thick, it's not going to go all around the mold like this. So now that we have that all nice in there, to this extra chocolate, we're just going to place it back into this little cup. Now from here, just grab your spatula and we're just going to scrape that away. Okay, so this is our first coat. I'm gonna go ahead and place this on my baking tray. So now we're gonna do the same technique to all of the half spheres. So now that I have my bombs out of the refrigerator, I'm gonna go ahead and do the same technique just one more time. So it is like nice and firm. We're gonna go ahead and add in just a second coat. And you wanna do this one a little bit quicker than the last one. Okay, so let's get started. So we have our hot plate here and we have our cocoa bombs. So we're gonna just take one of them, and to each and every one of them, you wanna place them on your hot plate and just swirl them there for like just a couple seconds, then take it out, and they're all nice and like clean from the sides. It's gonna be a lot easier for all of our bombs to be nice and even. So this one is uneven, as you guys can see. Let me focus that. So then we're just going to place it on the hot plate and just keep going. So next up, we're going to grab our cocoa mix. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons. And from here, we're both gonna add our marshmallows. Then we're gonna grab these right here, and we're just gonna add a couple. Now from here, we're gonna grab the tops now. We're gonna place them right here. And with the heat of the bottom, we're gonna go ahead and seal both of them together. And just hold it there for a couple seconds. Okay, and we're gonna do the same to the next one. Now I also went ahead and melted some white chocolate. Now this is going to bring like our Lucky Charms to life, because this kind of resembles like to milk, you know? So we're simply gonna do a drizzle. Next up, we're gonna grab some Lucky Charms. And since they're all different colors, you know, mismatched, that's what we're gonna do today and add like some really pretty fine crumbs on there. So I'm just gonna go ahead and start drizzling these. Now we want to work really quick here. We're going to grab two of these Lucky Charms and we're just going to crush them all over. Just like that. And then we can just keep on going to all of them. And let me just take off this big chunk that fell in there. I'm quickly going to add a mound of white chocolate in the centers. Now from here, we're going to add about 3 marshmallows. Okay, now that we have our marshmallows in there, we're going to pipe another mound of chocolate right in the center. And we're going to add any kind of Lucky Charm you guys will like inside. So then after that, we're going to grab some of our diamond dust, and I just happen to have like every color, so this is perfect, and I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit to each one of them. Just a little bit, not too much. Have the blue. And lastly, our purple. And we're all done. I'm just gonna let this set just a little bit more. We're gonna place them into our little liners and we're gonna be all done. So that is it for our Swiss Miss Lucky Charms chocolate bombs. I am so excited I got to share this with you guys today. And I have so many more chocolate bomb tutorials to come, so stay tuned. Now onto packaging. So you have many options. One of the many are going to be this little one right here. It closes like this, and this would be for like an individual sale or like a gift or anything. So basically we're just going to grab our bomb, and there's already a place for it, so we're just going to set it right here in the center. Just make sure it's nice and secure. And from there, it's not going anywhere. And around the sides, you can actually add in marshmallows. So let me go ahead and add some for you guys. So I'm just gonna add some all around the sides. And it's as easy as that, guys. We're just gonna close it. And now you have your own Lucky Charms chocolate bomb. And this is so easy, you just add it into 1 cup of steaming milk and it'll do its little magic there for you guys. And I have 2 more packaging ideas, so let me bring those over. Next up we have one of these right here. Now, lastly, we have the other idea, and this one is to put it like in a regular like 8-inch box. So you can also place them in here, totally optional, and just cover the bottom with a whole bunch of marshmallows. That'd be a super cute idea. But I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. And if you want a shout out on my next video, all you have to comment is clover emojis down below, and I'll be sure to give a lucky subscriber a shout out. I'll see you guys on the next one. Have a lovely day.